Hi, my name's Greg, and in this video, we will be creating a connected system. This video is the first part of our integration build series, so be sure to check out the other videos in the playlist linked in the description below. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment to see more videos like this one. Now imagine you are working on an Appian application that needs to connect to an external system. This external system has a multiple different integration endpoints and services a wide range of requirements for your application. Some integrations are simply retrieving information, while others are sending information to be processed by the external system. Whatever your needs are, you need to access this specific external system to do any of that. Introducing the Connected System Design Object. The Connected System Design Object is designed to hold the credentials needed to access an external system. If those credentials should change, a developer can open the object, update the credentials without affecting the connected integrations. And with object permissions, the connected system can be secured so that only specific developers can administer, edit, or use it when building integrations. Let's create a simple connected system. Consider you are developing an application that requires a list of universities. Rather than building and managing a database of all universities in the world, I will create a connected system that connects to an external system that already manages that list. Here I am an Appian designer, and I will click New Connected System. Here you can see a wide range of out-of-the-box connected system types for various external systems. Simply click on the desired connected system type, provide the required authentication information, and you are done. In our case, we are going to create an HTTP connected system from scratch, so I will click on HTTP. Next, we'll give it a name, IDE Universities CS, CS for connected system, and a description, connected system that contains the required credentials for the university's API. I will also add a system logo to provide a unique logo later when referenced in my application. I had already uploaded one earlier, so I'll reference it here. The base URL is a consistent URL prefix for all integrations in this external system. In our case, our base URL will be our university's URL. Later, when we create the integration object, we will append the URL with the specific path needed to retrieve a list of universities, or a subset of universities. Finally, we have authentication. These are keys to the door. The required authentication credentials that will allow Appian to connect to their system. All systems are different and may require a specific set of credentials. Using the dropdown, you will notice the various options available out of the box in this HTTP template. Since our external system does not require any authentication credentials, we will leave this as none. And that's it. Last thing to do is to go directly to configuring a new integration or simply creating the connected system object to be used later. Be sure to watch the other videos in the series and check out the other great videos in the integrations playlist. Bye for now.